everybody. I got a great big one today. This canvas is 48 by 36, 4 feet by 3 feet. Yeah, I think that's right. It's a big one. A lady would like a painting for over her couch, and she wants kind of the poppies. Her couch is like a tweed, like a gray and gold or beige kind of tweed. So I want to try and incorporate that in a little bit with a swipe and put the poppies up above. So I've got my canvas all taped. It's a level 3 because I thought it's so big that I want it to be sturdy. So I've got it taped and I've got my push pins in. Ooh. Okay. Spin her around. Try not to knock things over. My table is barely big enough. Here we go. Try and get everything out of the way. So I'm using, I'm going to flat it with white house paint mixed with glue, school glue, clear school glue, 50-50. And that'll be my base. And then I'm going to use some reds, a couple of different reds, a nice dark red. I wonder if I have enough of that. Maybe I better mix some more. I think there's enough. And then kind of a bright red, that's a festive red. This is a like a burgundy eggplant kind of color, so I'll put a little bit of that in, a little bit of black in the middle, and then I'm going to do some swiping. I'm going to use gold and silver instead of gray and beige, because I'm just afraid if I use the regular paint it'll be a bit too flat. So hopefully that'll work, and I don't think it'll clash with anything. So I'm going to do kind of swipe that up, and almost give it an effect of a background fence, you know, abstracty. And I think that'll tie it into her color scheme. So that's my plan. So I'm going to go ahead and flat. I think I mixed enough paint. Well, that's always the conundrum, but I think I'm good. So it's a little bit thicker, because this is going to be partially Dutch pours. This paint is a little bit thick, but I think I'll be okay. So here we go. Flooding. I gotta keep some back for the Dutch pours. And here I go. And I'm gonna take my rings off this time. Ugh, if I can. Ooh, maybe I can't. Oh well, clean them up after. Okay, let's spread that out. Just a little swipe tool I made just to smooth things out a little bit. Just at the top, because the back, whoops, most of it is going to be, at the bottom is going to be painted on. So just to make sure there aren't any really big ridges or anything. Fingerprints from me using my hands. Do it. Yep, that's good. And we'll just torch a little bit. Get some of the bubbles out. Pretty good. Okay, so now I'm going to do kind of some random silver and gold for some wiping. I'm not going to put any silicone in it because I don't want a bunch of cells in this. I want it to be kind of simple. Oops. Just going to put kind of bits of random gold in to kind of have it two-tone. Give the idea of fence. That should do it. And then what I'm going to use to swipe, I just use, you know, when you buy canvases, it comes with a bit of a cardboard corners on it. I'm going to use that to swipe. Gives you a nice straight edge. So here goes. I don't want to go too high up. Oh, forgot my paper towel. A little bit of pressure on. Yeah, that's perfect. Just a little hint. Pretty good. I want to just kind of cheat it a bit here. I would have preferred if it had run down, but I gotta move on. Let's see what's going on. All right, now the flowers. We don't want them too big, we don't want them too small. Oh my goodness, I got paint all over me. I'm going to start with my dark color. I just want to think about how I want them. I think one here, big one here. Oops, oh, my lid is stuck. So I think the biggest one is going to be there. Let's go up here. Maybe a little one there. Let's do a big one up here for the edge. Okay, that's good. Now we'll get red. This one, I think I would like to be my biggest one. Do a big one down there too. A little bit smaller up there. Whoops, almost out of red. Yikes! And I put this light red around the outside. Okay, I had to mix some more white. I'm gonna do these one at a time. Maybe two at a time. Yeah, maybe three at a time. Go for it. I don't want the paint to sit for too long because then it won't spread as much. So we'll do it that way. Okay, here goes. My cord's going to drag across. Am I going to be able to reach? This is going to be tricky. Ugh. Whoa. Okay. to do. Do this at the same time. A little bit of black in the center. Just a little bit. Just trying to find the logical spot where a center would be. Let's go there. And there. That should be enough. Airbrush. Cord is long enough to reach. Yep. Okay, here we go. So I just want to shape these a little bit. Okay. Okay, that's a good start. So I think now I am going to do a few more little flowers, but I think now I'm going to put in some stems. I'm just going to mix in a little bit of this nice kind of a moss green. Put some of that in. It'll give me kind of two-tone stems. That'll work. So if I pinch it like this, I'll be able to get a nice thin line. Ooh, it's not really where I want it. I'll have to work with that. I'm going to be doing some little things here. I'll probably put a bud there. There. So, got that done. Now, what I'd like to do is have a couple of kind of like, oops, I just see something I need to do here. We're going to do a little bud here. So, go over, oops, that's probably too much. Just a little dip-de-doo like that. So now I'm just going to kind of shape these a little bit. Okay, so now we're going to put like a little bud there. something with that little thing there. Gotta do something with that. Scoop it up. So I kind of blend the stems in, kind of cover them up a little bit. Make them look like they're in behind. My little buds are okay, I think. Gonna switch over to voiceover now. Never did that before. Just because I kind of am lost in thought and I talk nonsensical. So I felt that it needed some kind of smaller flowers to fill in. You know, there was too many big flowers all by them's own self. So I'm just filling in a little bit with smaller flowers. Just to kind of make it more random. So these ones are going to be smaller. They're not Dutch pour ones. They're just paint with, with the airbrush, which is fine. The red will be a little more vivid, which I kind of like. So I'm just going to do a little bit of that. I'm going to speed up. I think I can speed up. Okay, so I'm just taking a peek around at how things are looking. That I'm happy with. I'd like a bit more red and we need more red there. So now I'm just going around with the red and a bit of the black, and I just want to punch up the red. It's kind of getting swallowed in the white, and the black, you know, kind of keeps melting into it. So I just want to punch up the red a little bit. So I'm just kind of adding some red and spreading it out. I actually have had to do this a few times just so that I don't lose it all, you know, in the white, and it ends up being pink poppies. Poppies are red.
So I had to do that a few times, and I went over again with the black a few times because it was getting swallowed up. That happens. But as it dries, you can go back and, you know, touch up a little bit. So here I'm just, I usually do this when I'm doing flower paintings, is I do a little bit of spattering. So I usually pick a couple of the colors. I think I've got green there, the green mixture. I'm just kind of, I dip it in the paint and hit it a few times, not on the painting, in case you get any really big, you know, swaps of paint. And then I just kind of, I've got one big brush with the paint on it, and then I just smack it. I don't know if you can see it, but it's just kind of, I don't know, I find it ties the paintings in a bit. So I'm doing it with green, not everywhere, just kind of random all over, especially when you have a lot of white space at the top, you know, you just kind of ties it together. So I'll do it with the green, and then I'll get some red paint and do the same. I don't even wash the brush off in between because, you know, it's okay if it mixes up a little bit. You get, you know, varying shades. So I'll do the same thing with red. Oh, it sounds like I did wash the brush. Don't usually do that. Yeah, maybe I did. So now I'm just going to do it a little bit with the red. Just a straight red. Kind of fun to do that. I've never had, I mean, if you got a big splotch, you could just scoop it up and, you know, cover it with white or something. But, you know, it usually works pretty good. As long as you don't go overboard with it, test it a bit before you hit the canvas with it. It just makes it look a little bit more natural. Trick is not to overdo it. A little bit up in the corners. A little bit. Okay, I think that's about it. Stop! Stop!
So there it is, all dry. I let it dry for another, I don't know, 10 days or so, and then I'll varnish it. I think it turned out nice. My husband says if she doesn't like it, he wants it for our living room, so. A little close-up clip. I was going to add more black to the middle, but I think it's enough. I think it's neat. The paint kind of did some neat things. Yeah, look at that. That did it up all by its own self. And the buds turned out pretty good. Yeah, it's okay. I hope she likes it.